Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will answer a common Hibernate question about the management of bidirectional associations. But before we discuss it in detail, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified for new videos. Okay, let's dive into today's topic. Someone asked me this question on my blog. Updating both ends of a bidirectional association is an error-prone task. What's the best way to implement it in a reusable way so that you don't need to do it in the business code? There are two general ways to implement the management of bidirectional associations. You can add methods to your entities that manage the associations, or you can activate bytecode enhancement so that Hibernate manages the associations itself. You can use the first option with all JPA implementations. The second one is specific to Hibernate and enhances the bytecode of your entity classes at build time. Both of them make the management of bidirectional associations easier by automatically updating the other end of the association. Let's take a closer look at both options in the IDE. The domain model of this example is simple. One author has written one or more books, and each book was written by one author. Let's implement additional methods for these entities that help us manage the association. The general idea of this approach is simple. Instead of writing the code required to manage the association everywhere you add or remove an element, you just move the code into a method on each entity. I did that for the setAuthor method on my book entity. As you can see, it first updates the association on the provided author entity before it updates its author attribute. The implementation of a similar method on the author entity is even easier. The setAuthor method on the book entity already performs all the required steps to manage the association. So you just need to call it on the provided book entity. After you've done that, you can call these methods in your business code and it updates both ends of the association. Let's take a look at the second option, Hibernate's bytecode enhancement. This feature makes the management of bidirectional associations even easier. You just need to add a Maven or Gradle plugin to your build process, which will add the required code to the class files of your entities. The following configuration adds the Hibernate Enhance Maven plugin to your Maven build and generates the required code to manage bidirectional associations. That's all you need to do. During your next Maven build, the plugin will add additional code into the setter methods of the to-one sides of your bidirectional associations. This code updates the other end of the association so that you don't need to do it yourself. Let's run a quick build that executes this test case. As you can see, I instantiate and persist a new author and a new book entity. I only set the author attribute on the book entity. So without bytecode enhancement, these two assertions should fail because I didn't update the author side of the association. But as you can see here, the build executed the test case and it was successful. Thanks to Hibernate's bytecode enhancement, both ends of the association were updated. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!